In this lesson, we will learn how to put images in a LaTeX document. To put images, we have to use a package called graphicx. So first, we put a command use package graphicx with an X. So first, let me show you my file structure. So these are my images, and my program is this one, inserting images in a LaTeX document, and this is the folder path. So in C, I have a folder LaTeX in which my text file is residing, and there is a folder my images, and in this folder I have all these images. So this is a simple path I designed for this lecture. So there are different ways to include an image. So if you want to have your images in the same folder in which your program resides, then you don't have to give any path in your LaTeX document. But since I have a folder inside, so I have to include a path so that all my images are well organized in a separate folder. So I will include a command called graphicx path, and I have to put a pair of curly brackets, and inside this curly bracket another pair of curly bracket. And since my folder is in one step down, so I will put this dot is for current directory, and then inside the current directory I have a folder my images, and then I have to put another backslash. Don't forget to put this. You can also put an absolute path if you want, and I'll show you after this. So now inside a document where I want to put an image, so this is just a dummy text. For example, I want to put my image here. So in order to put an image, I should start an environment which is called figure environment. So begin figure, and let's end it first. And within that environment, I have to use a command include graphicx. And then I can put some options. I can put width, height, scale, angle. So these are some of the most used options. And in this curly bracket, I have to put the name of the file. So these are my files. So image-1, image-2, 3, and 4. So these are the names of the images. So let me include the first image. So image-1. So what is here? So first, let me compile without any scale or width or height. So see how it looks. So my text is aligned, and my image is of this size, which is covering nearly all the text width, and it is going towards the right. And this image looks a little bit bigger in size. How can I scale this? I can put a scale of 0.9. And if I recompile now, see if it comes a little bit towards center. Still it looks big. So let us put a scale of 0.5. It will reduce the size of the image. And now the image size has been reduced. And let's see if we can center the image. And now the image has been centered, and as you can see that this text is going a little bit beyond this square. So in this case, you must consider that your image starts somewhere in this area. So if you even if you center it, the whole image will be centered. So keep in mind that what you really want to center. If you want to center this square, then you have to keep your text within this limit. Otherwise, you will not get the desired result. Even this 1200 is going a little bit outer than square. So you should, when sometimes the image doesn't look like center, although it is centered. So first, you should prepare your image with an exact dimensions, and you should also know those dimensions. And in order to find the current dimension of the image, you just right click and properties and these details. So these are the dimensions of the image. 749 pixels into 563 high. So width and height. So you should know these dimensions, because sometime, for example, if I put this second image, so let's see the dimension of this image. So as you can see, this is a very wide image. It has 1100 pixels, and it is roughly a square image. 1100 by 1076, so it's a square image. So if I put this, so see what happens if I put image 2. So let me change this to image 2, and if I compile now, so see this image is going out because it's very big image. It is centered image, and it is 0.9 scale, so it's nearly roughly the full image. So let me reduce it to 0.3 of the scale, means 30% of the size, and then it will appear more like a as we want. And now as you can see that this image is looking in the center and appearing much better than before. So you have to prepare this image in exact dimension which you want, and then you will get the expected results, because sometimes you don't get result because there is some image, the blank part of the image, which is going outside this visible area and you think that it's not properly centering. So therefore you have to take into consideration all these type of things. You can rotate this image by putting an angle, for example, let's say 30 degrees, and now your image is rotated. This is making 30 degree with the horizontal. The left bottom is the center point of rotation and it rotates to 30 degree on the towards counterclockwise. If you want the other direction, you can put either minus 30 degree or 330 degree. So this is minus 30 degree. So in this way you can rotate the image. Now if you want to have an image of a particular size, so you can put width and height. Width equals 6 centimeter, height equals 5 centimeter. So now you are forcing LaTeX to put these dimensions. And these dimensions, sometime if you look carefully, this may distort your image if it's not in a proper proportion. So width to height ratio should be appropriate so that you can get a good image. So keep in mind that width to height should be the same. So first prepare the image in proper dimensions and then you will be able to get the results as per expectations. Putting images is very simple. Just begin this environment. Even if you don't begin this environment, let's remove this and try to compile. You can still put the images, but within the environment, now if you look here, your whole text is centered and it looks a little bit odd because we want only image to be centered. We want to play with the image. Therefore, it's good to have this begin and end environment of the figure. And if you want to give an absolute path, so look at my absolute path. So the absolute path of my file is c/latex/my images. So I can also put this path here. So c:\latex/my images. This will also work. Let me recompile. And this path also works fine. So you can give the path from the current directory with dot or the absolute path of the image folder. So you can also put another path to this graphics path. For example, let me create another folder. So this is my images. If I want to have my images in two folders, so I can create another folder and let me name it my images-2. And now if I put one of these images, for example this image 4, I just cut this and I put in this folder, let's say like this. And now I want to add this second folder into my path. And now I can include this folder from the current directory, my images-2, and then put another backslash at the end. And now there is only one file in this folder, which is 4. So let me recompile and hopefully I will be able to extract that image. And now you can see this is image 4. So this is from the other folder, from this folder. We have fold. So in this way, you can add multiple paths into this graphics path command. If you want to put images in a separate page, so you give option to this begin figure environment. If you put T, T means the top of the page. The other options you have, I can put here. B means the bottom of the page. And P means on a separate page. It's already on the top of the page, so let me put on a separate page, P. Let me compile. As you can see that after all the text, my images on a separate page. So if you want all your images on a separate page, you can put it here. And the other advantage of figure environment is that you can also give some captions and some labeling. If you want to refer this image somewhere else, you can put a label here, and you can also put a caption here. If you want the put caption at the end, so just before and figure, you can put your caption, a scan image, for example. This is my title of the image. So now if I compile, as you can see that this is the caption of the image. If you want the size of the image to be equal to the text width, which you are not sure how much is, so you can put width equals text width, / text width. So now this is the full text width image. So you can put 0.5 / text width, and the figure will be half of your text width. So if you want to scale figure like this, you can do that. So this is half of your text width. So for example, if you have two figures, so you can put half of your text width and then the other figure as besides this, the half of the text width. So let me copy this and paste here, and I put the image number one here. So the best thing is put the width a little bit less than 0.5. 0.4 is better, because otherwise it will be at the very edge. So we want a little bit of margin on both sides. And then instead of include graphics, we have to use another command, / subfloat. And then you can put this command inside your subfloat. And similarly, the second one, subfloat. And you have to include a package, use package subfig, and this will give access to this command subfloat. And now if I recompile, I don't have this package at the moment because this is a new installation. So now as you can see that the LaTeX is asking me to install the package, and I simply install it. And now as you can see that both of our figures are side by side. So this is how you put two images beside each other. So in this way you can insert images.